too. Starting a little warm out there.
It is. It was cool this morning.
Yeah, it was nice. Temperatures are already where yesterday's highs were yesterday. Mm. We've got a lot more heating left to do.
Heat wave is on.
This afternoon, yes. It's hoping to create a few clouds over the area. Here's a time lapse view from this morning of Blues Lake Margo. Look at that sky. It's pretty. Pretty blue sky. A few high, thin clouds work their way in first. And then we'll start to see some fair weather clouds here in the next few moments starting to pop up over the area. And again, not very cloudy at all today. We're looking at mostly sunny conditions over the region. We're not going to expect any rain at all today. Tomorrow may be a little bit of a different story, but certainly not going to dominate your forecast. There's certainly some storm energy coming out of the Midwest, and the prevailing steering winds are going to take this energy and start to swing it through the Ohio Valley and eventually into West Virginia, and possibly, if it holds together long enough, could bring some showers or a few storms for the first half of tomorrow into the picture. You can see there's a cold front there. Look how much cooler it is in Fargo than Kansas City. There's a 31 degree swing in temperature there. Where the rain has moved through Chicago, it's cooled down to 69 degrees, and we're still holding on to a pocket of cool air that's fighting a losing battle. Warm, steamy conditions have been building across the south, and we're going to see that build back locally here for the weekend. Most of next week, if not all of it. So we're not going to see too many changes once we move into tomorrow. Got a couple of weird colors in the contour map. Some of the reporting stations having some problems earlier. They seem to have been resolved. 71 currently at PTI Airport. A little bit closer view. 75 already in Burlington. Martinsville was having the issue earlier, but again, resolved now. And 72 degrees in Winston-Salem. Should see upper 70s to near 80 degree weather today, as opposed to barely getting to 70 yesterday. I talk a lot about dew points, and the thing you just need to remember about it is once we get above 55, you start to feel the moisture in the air. I'm already feeling it already outside, although then again, I was in a wool jacket, so maybe that had something to do with it too. But once you get above 65 in the dew point column, everyone starts to feel uncomfortable, and we're heading down that path. We're going to start to see that humidity building in for tomorrow, starting to increase the moisture in the air, and mid to upper 60 in the dew point column is a good possibility. And once it's here, it's hard to get rid of. You need a very strong dry air mass to move in, much like the one we just had, and that's going to start to scour things away. As far as temperatures go, upper 70s, I think an average high today for the Triad, mainly sunny, west-southwest winds at 5 to 10, 77 degrees in the foothills this afternoon, with a lighter southwest wind and mountain temperatures up near 72 degrees today. Chance for showers and storms somewhat limited for tomorrow, about a 20, maybe as high as 30% chance that we'll see a late morning to midday, even early afternoon, a chance for a passing shower or storm. Temperatures will get close to 90 several days this weekend and into early next week.